Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We are... Is he just a commoner? Yeah. We're still in the Elfsong Tavern, and we're going to look around, and we're going to look at a lot more places, because this is our special 150th episode, so it's going to be probably over an hour in length. So, enjoy.
Why me?
Why not? That was mega zoomed in there. Sir Demac?
Alright.
Hello, pal.
Can I help you, friend? If not, please do not hesitate to get out of my face. You're disturbing my fun. I'm sorry to disturb you, friend. I'll just be on my way. That was weird. Okay.
Alright.
We just get out of each other's way here.
Yep. Alright.
$10 in there. Nothing there. Looks like there could be something there, but nope. Lady Elith Elendera.
Something you require?
Good eve to you. I am Elith, the owner and proprietor. I trust the elf song will fit your needs, whatever they should be. I should be wary of the clientele if I were you. Everyone is quite on edge of late. Maybe they should be wary of me. Yeah, that's my... I was just saying, but... apart from looking a little haggard, everyone seems quite ordinary. What have I to fear here? The Elfsong is somewhat of a refuge for the less appreciated members of society. You will find that the city patrols give us a wide berth, though we are not unprotected. Thievery is kept in check by the willingness of our patrons to answer with a blade, though I suppose this is successful just as often as it is not. We tend to go through a large number of customers, though we keep the smart ones. Noted. Thanks. Well, there is somebody there. A merchant.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormier.
A fine and lovely day to you. Would you be interested in any of my fine odds and ends? I've endeavored to keep prices reasonable, even in spite of the shortages of late. Let's see what you have for offer. Ooh. Okay, protection scrolls. We actually know what they are. The One Gift Lost. Necklace of Missiles. The naming of this necklace originates from its only owner, Ikeda Morneve, who quested to regain his kidnapped daughter. Not many would help the determined father, but a kind and generous mage bestowed this item on him to aid his cause. Alas, the necklace was lost when Ikeda dropped it into the Emmerflow River while fending off bandits upon a suspension bridge. Fortunately, it is rumored that the item was not needed to reunite the family once again. Charge abilities. Missile Blast. 66 fire save versus spell for half. 50-foot range. 15-foot radius. That's pretty sweet. Anyone can use it? Anyone except for Wizard Slayer. I think I'll take that. Let me just look at this stuff first. The Protector plus one. The Protector. Amulet of Protection plus one. The Royal Guard of King Faerûn, ruler of Impilter, were given the Protector as an honorary show of status. Unfortunately, members of the Guard had trouble coming to a consensus among themselves as to whom the amulet should go. After years of internal hostility, the item was lost and the guards replaced by less greedy individuals. So helps with armor class and saving throws. And then shield amulet. This amulet can be activated by a simple command word and touch. with each use acting as one charge. The effect is a duplication of the first level wizard spell shield. For the duration of the spell, the wearer will have a base armor class of 4 and a further +2 armor class bonus versus missiles. The wearer also becomes immune to the spell magic missile for the duration. This is cumulative with any modifiers due to shields and magical devices. I like that immunity to magic missile. And finally, final item we're going to look at, Topsider's Crutch, or Ring of Intravision. Merchants that dare the risk of trading with the Drow of the Great, or Drow of the Great Rift, are often given these items to aid in their movements underground. I don't think that's necessary. What do we have? I know I have an amulet that Imowen just gave me. I feel bad replacing it already. Oh, I wonder if we can sell anything, actually. Identified. These are the +1 bullets, yeah. We got a lot of winter wolf pelts. Okay. So, no amulet. I've got this one. She has a protector +1. I knew one of us had it. So I might as well just get another. Someone can use it. And this one gift lost. Because I'm full, right? That's why I can't buy it. Jeez, this is getting ridiculous.
Sure.
I'm kind of wounded.
No, you aren't. Here. Just making her leader temporarily to buy these two things.
Good job.
Thanks. I think we just saved 400 gold.
As leader, I plan to make us stinking rich.
Okay, so the one gift lost is a good thing to have. I think I'll give that to her then. And so she has that. Armor class 5. I think I'll give myself the other one. Sorry, Imowen. But I'm already replacing the necklace you just gave me. It looks just the same, though. Now, hopefully I won't sell it. Armor class should go down. Oh, this item cannot be equipped due to other magical equipment you're currently wearing. Well, guess I'm putting this back on. I had no idea. Who else could wear it? Maybe I should give it to Imuin after all. I'll give the... Can I wear this? Yes. No. it must be because of the ring? Or what is she wearing? That bracers? Does that go? It's because we're wearing plus stuff. Sorry, guys. Can anyone else wear this? It's getting challenging. Okay. Armor class, -1. Minsk is wearing it, of all people. That's cool. So I got -1. Wow, -4 for Kagan. No wonder these people kick butt. Alright, I wonder if I can sell this guy anything. I didn't check with the others.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
I'm actually holding on to that. I don't know if I want to use that at some point.
Things going.
Check these rooms. See if anyone's in here. There is! There's a ruffian.
So I kicked him in the head till he was dead.
Get out of here, you morons. Does it look like I want to talk to you? Another ruffian. Well, they're probably gonna attack if we open even that thing in there. Have I been in here? I think so. Alright, let's get out of here.
Alright.
Done with the elf song for now. Kagan encumbered. Alright.
I don't want.
Why me?
I think I checked that already. History of Kalimshan, I've read that. General store, okay. What's his name? Maltz?
Welcome to my humble establishment.
Hello there, I'm Maltz. I know my place doesn't look much like a store, but I think it suits my purposes quite nicely. What is it that you'd like? I don't know. Actually, nothing. We need to sell these winter wolf pelts. that a bookcase?
I serve the flaming fist.
Never mind.
Sure. Sure.
All right, all right.
Sleeping man. No can wake. Nobody else.
Altruistic moron.
We're about to steal something from someone. It's not that altruistic. Better?
Sure. All right.
Glad you agree.
All right.
What place is this?
All right, all right.
Sure.
Hi. Archeon.
Why me?
Yeah, mate.
I got a dirty deed for you. How about you go down into the sewers and bring me up a body? Now, I don't ask questions about how come about them, and I don't want any questions about what I use them for. Bring them to me when you find them. We're finding quite a lot of people who want bodies from the sewers. A necromancer named Archeon is in need of corpses and has singled me out for the task of finding one. According to him, the sewers are the best place for that sort of thing. If I were to decide to procure one for him, I can find him again in his house just south of the Elfsong Tavern. And there's someone else who wants bodies as well. I forget. I forget, but he's in the Elfsong Tavern itself. Greetings.
Pleasure to meet you.
Surely there are more interesting places for you to be. This is but a simple common home.
Yep.
Good job.
If you say so. She's following her. Actually following, it's just random. Surely there'd be another room for you to stand in. Here you go. Simple dagger, nope. What about this? A potion of insulation. Ah, nah.
I serve the flaming fist.
Oh, God. Back here by Maltz. Did I buy this stuff?
Why me?
I didn't buy anything from him, actually. Was that upstairs? Going back up here.
Sure.
Was there someone over here? That's what I'm trying to remember.
All right, all right.
A sleeping man. You don't see anyone. That's right, we did take that stuff.
Alright. Alright.
So I need to be saving
sure.
more often. Oh, yeah.
Hey, how are things going?
Alright. Alright.
Yeah, mate.
Alright, done.
Pleasure to meet you.
Alright, alright.
Can she see me from here? Okay.
All right.
Now we're done.
All right. Sure.
McFeely? McFeely.
Hello, pal.
Speedy delivery coming through. Must inform the Grand Dukes of the Nashkel Mine's liberation. They must be told iron supplies will return to normal once trade routes are reliable once again. Speedy delivery coming through. Okay, well, you don't seem to be going much of anywhere. The door to this house is rotting off its hinges. You assume the house has been abandoned for years. Branwyn says, I have nothing to say to any of you. Really? Did a reputation go down again? We're average. She's not happy with us.
Yep.
All right.
Sure.
Oh, the patter of little feet. Mr. Ken? A girl?
All right.
I want my mommy.
Well, where is she then? Just because you're tough doesn't mean you're the boss of me. Get out. No.
You funny looking.
This time they actually said it. Alright, Mr. Ken's over there. Anyone in here? Nope. Mrs. Ken?
Hey, your friend.
Excuse us, but we do not have time for talking. That's fine, we'll just look around the place then. Mr. Ken?
You need something, stranger.
What do you want? We're preparing a big celebration and don't have much time, if you'll excuse us. A big celebration.
Hey, how are things going?
Viola.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
I am so happy. Huh. Is the celebration about you? Blue stone necklace, hey. Oh, this here's the good room. Wake up. Waiting for Viola to leave. Issue of the Bell and Adapts, I have it. Done.
All right. Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
Malt's the weapon shop. Okay. Sorcerous Sundries. Interesting. Ordulinian and Halbazardrin. Interesting names.
Why me?
Yeah, mate.
Ah, weary adventurers. The roads of this fair city are lined with fools, are they not? And two of the greatest are Archeon and Nympher. Necromancers fighting over trinkets and baubles of little use or value. I assure you, they are more trouble than they are worth. You're better off steering clear of them. The priest Ordulinian. Has passed on a strange warning regarding two necromancers engaged in a long-standing but petty feud. Their names are Archeon and Nympher, which you met Archeon, and I have been advised to steer clear of their meddling while in Baldur's Gate. All right, and this guy?
Yes?
And who might you be, then? Humph? Come to check out the wares of old Halbazar? Well, be quick about it. And mind you don't get fidgety when we talk payment. You knew when you came in the door that my wares were magical. Premium items demand a premium price. Could he help us with the egg? I have this egg here. I was told I should show it to someone who knows about magic, or I would have a nasty surprise in a week. Let me see. Oh, aha. Yes, that one is alive and kicking. You know what that will be, yes? A wraith spider, and a very powerful one it is. This egg is magically treated to get the essence of the spider's magic. That is what makes it so powerful. But the egg is still alive. Carrying it near your body heat was enough to make it warm, so it will hatch soon. I could treat it, try to kill it while preserving as much of the power as possible. I can't guarantee the outcome, though, but it should remain a usable magic item. This would cost you 1,000 gold, and I need a scroll of... No, make that 1,200 gold, and I do it right away, using one of my private scrolls. I know which one to use for it. Decide quickly. Cannot risk that thing hatching inside my shop. Yeah, that sounds good. Please do it. Very well. Let me take it. Quickly. This will take just a moment. And a bit of baking. You're cooking the thing? Here it is. I had to force it a bit, and it is dead now. It has lost quite a lot of its power, and it, well, doesn't look quite so attractive anymore. It's the best that I could do. The unknown egg. The unknown egg. Is it back here? Where's the unknown egg? Was it done, quest? Here it is. The egg is permanently preserved now. It is still a magical item and might be of some use. It was the egg of a wraith spider ready to hatch. That danger is over now. We've gained... Okay, we lost egg and gained egg of the frozen spider. This is a preserved egg of a wraith spider. Worn as an Ioun stone, it surely looks disgusting, but it protects the wearer against being magically held. Oh, nice. The wearer is immune to hold creature. Charisma lowered by 3 points while equipped. Oh, boy. Oh, we put it on our head. Alright. I'll keep it in mind. A harmonica. Huh. Tarmaniel's Warmth. This mouth organ was created by Tarmaniel, a human bard well known throughout the land of Sembia. Tarmaniel was keen to travel and liked to share information amongst fellow bards. When played, the harmonica gives off a sound like no other, which warms the hearts of its listeners. Unfortunately, he also had a love of gambling and lost a harmonica in a card game somewhere in Baldur's Gate. So it's a plus one bonus to charisma, plus one AC for the party. Usable only by bard or monk. Yeah, I don't want that. Cassandra's lute. The lion's courage. Cassandra started playing the lute when she was 5 years old. By the age of 14, she was a master performer. Her father, Faerûn Coriads, a gifted elven luthier, created a special lute for her 16th birthday, made from mystical woods close to the Lake of Dreams. The lute was played to give confidence and courage when played. Cassandra traveled many lands and played in many places with the instrument. Then, during a visit to her homeland Evermeet, the ship that bore her encountered high seas and the lute was lost overboard. The ship was wrecked on Araska, but Cassandra survived only to search for her lute to this day. When played, the performer gains a series of confidence and courage. Plus one Thaco, strength increased by one, immunity fear, 5 temporary points. Ooh, we got here. Red Wizard Spellbook. Once a book of flames, once in the hands of a Red Wizard Archmage, this book was stolen by a runaway slave and smuggled out of Thay into the safety of the Dale Lands. The book is bound in human skin, the result of countless slave experiments. As a result, it has an aura only evil characters can use. When open, a flame reaches out for the target. 2d3. Instantaneous. Huh. So I've got these different arrows and such. Potions. I think one of us have this. Ice Storm. Level 4. When this spell is cast, great hailstones pound down for 4 rounds in a 30 feet diameter area and inflict 2d8 points of cold damage to any creatures within the area of effect. Also, anyone that remains within the area of effect takes 2d8 cold damage each round for 4 rounds. I'm liking that. Ice Storm. I don't think we have that. Hold on. Level 4. Yeah, I definitely don't have it. Improved invisibility. It's gotta be like evocation, right?
Yes.
Oh, it is? Okay, thanks. let's see. Too bad it has stuff all the way down here. Well, that's just summoning one. Yeah. Well, he only has one of them, unfortunately. Cone of Cold. Level 5. Animate dead. Well, let's buy that. Melf's Minute Meteors. Cool. The spell creates several small globes of fire, one for each experience level the wizard has obtained, which are held in the wizard's hand in place of her usual weapons. The meteors can be hurled at targets up to 90 yards away and are treated as missiles with a plus 5 bonus to the attack rolls. Each meteor bursts into a 1-foot diameter sphere upon impact, inflicting 1d4 points of damage plus an additional 3 points of fire damage to any creature struck. The wizard may hurl up to 5 missiles per round. Well, for experience level, up to 5, which means it's just going to be 5. Hold undead, protection from cold, grease, armor, burning hands. Sinking cloud, we have that one. Power word sleep. This is just for one creature then. Yeah, not a. So it's not. It's different from the sleep spell. I'm sure it's more powerful as well, but just for one target. When a wizard calls upon a power word sleep spell, she causes a comatose slumber to come upon one creature other than undead and certain other creatures specifically excluded from the spell's effects. The creature targeted must have less than 20 hit points and gets no saving throw. Magically sleeping opponents can be attacked with substantial bonuses. The sleep effect will last for 5 rounds. It has no effect on creatures with more than 20 hit points. Well, that's going to be a lot of creatures we come against, so I'm not even bother buying that. Monster summoning 2 is a level 4. Look at that. Making sure it's the same. Chaos. Level 5. The effects of this spell are identical to the 4th level spell Confusion in all respects. The victims wander around as if in a daze, sometimes wandering away, sometimes attacking either friend or foe. If the victim is 4th level or lower, she does not receive a saving throw versus the effects. However, if the victim is 5th level or higher, she receives a save versus spell with a minus 4 penalty. The spell lasts for the duration or until a successful dispel magic is cast. Well, they're going to buy it, yeah, because it's level 5. Sunfire, wow. Polymorph self. When this spell is cast, the wizard is able to assume the form of another creature. The caster also gains the physical mode of locomotion and breathing as well. This spell does not give the new forms other abilities such as special attack and magic, nor does it run the risk of the wizard changing personality and mentality. When the spell is cast, for the duration of the spell, the caster may transform into any of the new forms at any time, and as many times as she wishes. The caster gains the natural attacks of the new form in some cases, and may use weapons in others. The mental attributes of the wizard remain the same, however all the physical attributes are attained from the new form. Also, any natural protections that the new form offer are conferred to the wizard, such as the resistance to missile and crushing damage possessed by the slime. Yeah, I want that. Teleport field? That sounds funny. The wizard instigates a teleportation effect that randomly teleports all enemies in this area for the duration of the spell. Teleport field is best used against multiple enemies, serving to confuse them and allowing the wizard to concentrate on activating her defenses. This is level 4? Yeah, I'll take that too. Farsight. The caster is able to view an area of an unexplored map. After casting the spell, simply click on the section of the map that you want to view. For the duration of the spell, the caster can spy on that area, noting creatures and fortifications. Could be handy. Secret word. When this spell is cast, a target creature will dispel one spell protection of 8th level or lower. The spells that are affected by this are minor spell turning, minor globe of invulnerability, spell immunity, spell deflection, spell turning, and spell shield. The target's magic resistance, if any, does not affect this spell. You know, I wonder if it would work on that thing that Karak, is that its name? The thing that killed us over by the Firewine bridge. Secret word, right? Yeah. Contagion. This spell creates a major disease and weakness in a creature. The afflicted individual is immediately stricken with painful and distracting symptoms, boils, blotches, lesions, seeping abscesses, and so on. Strength, dexterity, and charisma are reduced by 2. The afflicted creature is also slowed. These effects persist until the creature receives a cure disease spell. Remove curse. We know that. Remove curse. The wizard is usually able to remove a curse on an object, on a person, or in the form of some undesired sending or evil presence. A remove curse is also, we have our priest can cast that, so I'm not going to bother with getting that. Greater Malazon. Adversely affects all the saving throws of her enemies. The area is affected to apply to all hostile creatures within the area of effect. Opponents under the influence of this spell make all saving throws at a penalty of -4. Yeah, so basically cast this and then cast all your other spells. Let's look at that. Ataluk's Resilient Sphere. When this spell is cast, the result is a globe of shimmering force that encloses a subject creature as it fails to save versus a spell. Right, so you cast your Greater Malazan and then this. The sphere is completely immune to all damage. In fact, the only method of removing the sphere is a successful dispel magic. Hence, the creature caught inside the globe is completely safe from all attacks, but at the same time completely unable to affect the outside world. Good for a breather. One turn, so basically, yeah, 10 rounds. That's not a... That's an alteration, okay. I think she can't use enchantment. Spirit armor. This spell is very similar to the third level spell Ghost Armor in that it creates a corporeal barrier around the target's body for the duration of the spell. The spell, however, actually taps into the target's life force in order to create the barrier. The armor itself is weightless and does not hinder movement or spell casting at all. The spirit armor does not work cumulatively with any other armor. However, dexterity bonuses still apply, as well as magic rings and shields. While in effect, the AC of the recipient will be set to 1, as if she were wearing plate mail. Also, due to the magical nature of the spell, she will also receive a +3 bonus to save versus a spell. There is a danger, however, as when the spell runs out, the external portion of the spell is temporarily of the spirit is temporarily lost, inflicting 2d4 points of damage upon the target. I want that. For both of our casters. Wait, this is... That's enchantment, so I don't think she can use Greater Malazan. Polymorph spells, alteration, of course. Do we get two? I don't think so. Sunfire is level 5. I'm not going to bother looking at level 5 stuff. Minor Globe of Invulnerability. The spell... It's abjuration. The spell creates an immobile, faintly shimmering magical sphere around the caster that prevents any first, second, or third level spells from penetrating, i.e. the area of effect of such spells does not include the area of the Minor Globe of Invulnerability. This includes innate abilities and some effects from devices. However, any type of spell can be cast out of the magical sphere, and these pass from the caster of the globe to their subject without affecting the minor globe. Fourth and higher level spells are not affected by the globe. I'm buying at least one. We're so full. Okay, never mind. Could have carried more. Alright, well, let me look at her. She... She's an invoker. May not learn or cast any spells of the enchantment schools. Minus 15 penalty when scribing scrolls from other schools. Okay. Alright, so enchantment. Otherwise, anything is good. So that globe of invulnerability. Let's just get two of them.
Such menial tasks.
Did I get this monster summoning too? Not sure. Haste is good too. Okay, just checking to see if I got monster summoning too. I got one of them. Maybe we should get another one. And what about haste? I know I didn't buy it, but do we know haste? Haste is, you know, we just get that. Haste is level 3, I think. So one more of those. Oh crap. That's monster summoning 1. Damn it. It's not the one I wanted. Well, that was expensive. Haste. Where's haste? Haste makes waste. Level 3. Detect Illusion, Dark Charm, Small Magic, Fireball, Flame Arrow, Ghost Armor, Bold Person, Lightning Bolt, Non-Detection, Long Missiles, Magic, Slow. Well, I don't have it. Do you have it? No. Alright, two hastes. We need two hastes. And then we're done here. Actually, get on with exploring and stuff. Done. We'll play with this stuff later when we go sleep.
I don't want to talk.
I wonder if some of us might not have Monster Summoning 1. Level 3. I think we might not even know it, either of us. We should just as well, because we don't know it. That's fine. Okay.
Sure.
There's an upstairs. Oh, wow. Just check upstairs.
Sure.
Nemane says, oh, look, what a cute little party. Invading our space. We're preparing a ritual, and you all but ruined it. I'm sorry. Am I interrupting something? Like an extremely difficult spell, perchance. Yes, I would have to say that maybe you are interrupting something. I'm very, very sorry. I'll leave now. What does it matter now? Do what you will. And he leaves. Okay.
Sure.
Okay. That's done. Sorcerous Sundries.
Why me?
Niklos? Who are these people? Just commoners? Hail.
Yeah, stop a moment. I've got a word or two you need to hear.
You do, huh? Ah, you're a fine group of mercenaries, are you? Leastwise, that's the word on the street, that you'll do the odd job here and there. I've a boss who'd like to have a word with you if he can spare the time. He don't ask for free, though, and here be 50 gold just to hear him out. $50 just to listen? That's a fair deal. Lead on. A wise choice of action. Now just follow me, and I'll show you the way to the guild. If you're asked the password, it's Faerûn. Oh, like Faerûn and the Grey Mouser. When you're in the guild, just look for the man named Alatos Ravenscar Thuibold. Branwyn says, I like not the looks of this sapphire. This one has a furtive manner, and I trust not the suspicious set of his face. He would not be so cautious lest he had something to hide from Tempest's sight. Don't you be staying there all day. Come on. A youngster named Niklos gave me 50 gold to meet with his master. I am to follow him to a nondescript building. If I am asked for a password, Faerûn should be my response. Okay. Right over here? Alright. I should walk right into a trap or something.
Hi, friend.
Hi. You there! What are you doing in this place? Better get out of here. Unless, of course, you know the password. Yeah, I know the password. Well, if you know the password, then spill it. Faerûn. That's right, pal. You all can go in now. Okay.
All right.
I swear she dropped her purse, and I just picked it up for her. I never did... Wait a second. You're no guard, just a nosy ne'er-do-well interrupting my pickings. Off! Lest I pin you floor-wise. You're a queer fellow.
Such menial tasks.
Really, so hard for us to get in here?
All right.
All right, all right.
Throwing daggers and a dart. Same. Took the gold.
Sure.
What is this place?
Sure.
There's a rogue standing right there.
Hi, friend.
You have an unfamiliar mug, so you must be new to town, eh? We'll take a long walk seawise. Tain't enough lootings for the sneaksmen already here, so keep your hands in your own pockets and we'll get along just spanky dandy. What if I don't want to get along spanky dandy? Rogues. Plenty of them.
Hi, friend.
Pleasure to meet you.
If you're quite enough drawing attention to me, I should like to make for some shadows now. Hard to blend with an unsuspecting crowd when the likes of you come barging up.
Hi, friend.
Normally I don't give the hairs of a sweets rat patoot about local concerns, but now I cannot even buy a new set of picks because of the iron shortage.
So I kicked him in the head till he was dead.
Intriguing. Is that stairs down? If it is, we can't get down.
So I said daggers drawn with him, and he drops the swag and runs.
Gnarlin Darkwalk.
So I said daggers drawn with him, and he drops the swag and runs.
You said that. Here now, I know of you. New sneaksman you be. I cannot see no need. Alatos need but look at home to find a dab at thievery. Mayhaps we be testing your talent, for your rank riders bungle the score. You up to me task? I have no idea what you just said. Do you speak common? Feh! You be no thief if you can't speak the cant. You talk with Alatos before you get killed. Now hop the twig and get thee hence, you jackanapes. In the Thieves Guild, I met one Gnarlin, but I couldn't understand anything he said. I kind of had an idea, but... Husam?
Greetings, fellow rogues.
My name's Husam. I've heard quite a bit about your exploits. Hick! You really caused the Iron Throne some trouble, haven't you? I'd like to talk with the bunch of yous. What says you? Okay, what do you have to say? Yours the mercs have been tangling with. Hick! The Iron Throne, aren't you? Burp. Wells, I'm Husam, and I've kept informed on most of your doings. Listen well to what I've got to tell you. You know what? I hates the Iron Throne. They took my store, my money, and my wife. They took my whole life, they did. Excuse me. Now I've got... All I got is this damn horse piss to think I used to works for those manure piles. Get on with it. What do you want to talk to us about? Wells, I wanted to talk about the Iron Thrones. Ask me anything's about... Hick! Those manure eaters, and I'll tell you. I work for them, remember? Okay, Husam, who are the leaders of the Iron Throne? The leaders of the Iron Throne is Riltar and Shavest. He's the big guy, sent by the even bigger guys down in Sembia. This whole operation is his baby. He has two other guys, Brunos and Thaldorn. Brunos is a big, dumb, drunk half-orc. Damn half-breed should never hold his liquor. Thaldorn is a pansy. Oh, yeah, I literally forgot. There's Saravok. He's the son of a Riltar. He's a mean cuss. Is that enough for you guys, or do you want to know more? What are the Iron Throne's plans? The Throne's plans. They want to make money, always more money. But I know this, their leaders, the three biggins, they're going to candle keeps they are. Burp, something big. Something huge is going to happen there. I'm tired now. I needs to go home and sleep. If you ever needs me, you can find me at the Elfsong Tavern. Goodbye, burp. Huh. Husam says that the leaders of the throne are Brunos, Thaldorn, and Riltar. Hey, Diny here, got some free time? I thought that thou dost not need to talk to me anymore. Huh? What you saying that for? Never mind, I suppose I had better listen to thy question, or I'll never have your curious inquisitions end. Yep, that's me, Imwin the Persistent. So I was wondering why you came all the way out here to the Sword Coast. Nothing too interesting here. Well, there is Waterdeep, home of Elminster, but since most people will get to meet him, it's not all that special. I suppose there are some other places like Skullport or such. Those might be interesting to visit, though most of the places aren't exactly part of the coast. Dinah here quickly jumps in as Imran takes a breath. Thou shouldst know that there is much more to any area than meets the eye, but as to specific reason Minsk and I traveled hither, it is that I needed to. Needed to, huh? Sounds kind of vague. You aren't trying to dodge me, are you? Wherefore would I do such a thing? I have answered thine question. Make what thou wilt of it. I don't know. It really sounds like you're trying to dodge my question. Hey, you listen to me? Dinah here. Hey, wait up. Don't leave me behind. The drunk who... The drunk Husam told us that the Iron Throne leaders have gone to Candlekeep, for what purpose we do not know. Husam told us that we can find him at the Elfsong Tavern. Though he is a blubbering drunk, he seems to know a great deal. And the leaders of the Iron Throne are Brunos, Thaldorn, and Rialtar. Yes, and that. That's like another entrance to get there. Hmm. Alright, I have a feeling our friend who summoned us is back there. Alatos Ravenscar Thuibild and Ressar. In the bookcase. No.
Apologies, but you must die!
Don't bother me. Do you know who I am? I'm an envoy of the mighty nation of Halrua. And if you value your miserable life, you'll step away immediately. Okay. Let's talk to him.
Welcome, my little friends. Please, relax and keep your weapons at your sides.
No need for hostility. I simply must apologize for the manner of my thieves. I suppose a Thieves Guild must keep a measure of malice about it, but it does tend to put a cloud over introductions. I am Alatos Thuibild. Thuibild? But though I thank you not to mention that too often. You are Sapphire, of course. Be not surprised, there are very few people in Baldur's Gate I cannot name. You've been out here for only a few days, and you have already made quite a stir. Your interest in me is flattering, though I question your intent. Oh, I don't intend to flatter, merely to assure you that you have been watched since you entered the city. As for my intent, I do have a proposition for your group to consider. A small task, really, best suited to someone unknown here. I am quite sure that the membership of a Thieves Guild would include several people capable of whatever you ask. Danger of being recognized seems a minor concern if one is able to be not seen at all. So why do you need me? Shrewd, very shrewd. I do indeed have many fine individuals of exceptional skill, but a large number of them are vacationing at the garrison this season. The guard have been exceptionally vigilant, what with the banditry on the roads, and to their credit, they have captured several of my best people. I am sure that in the history of guilds, we are the first to experience a shortage of thieves. What exactly is it you would have me do? And what would be the reward for this service? How well can you afford to pay? Oh my. It is quite a bit of intrigue, actually. A local wizard by the name of Shandalar makes his home in a moored Halruin skyship. We've met Shandalar over in Olgoth's Beard. It would appear that he has the knowledge to reproduce these flying marvels and is currently organizing the sale of the receipt to the Grand Duchess Leah Janath. He has drawn up a set of rituals and has procured an artifact fragment and an ancient statuette vital to the spell that keeps the ships aloft. These he has divided amongst his daughters until the deal is to proceed. I have been contacted by a representative of the Halruins, and they have no wish to see scores of flying ships manufactured in every port. You are to infiltrate the place of exchange, steal the ingredients, and return here with them. Simple enough. You would be well paid, enough gold to give you a backache, and, if I am well pleased, mayhaps a magical weapon or two. Perhaps a little more, perhaps a little less. It entirely depends upon your performance. I don't know if I want to go around stealing so many things. Plus, we've helped the Chandelier before. Not good enough. I wish a set price with half the coin in my purse beforehand. I'll not be uncertain about what awaits when the task is through. I see. Well, having carefully considered your terms, I've decided that you are in no position to speak to me in such a manner. My offer is more than generous, and you could not hope to do better unless you burgle the Ducal Palace itself. You have but a yes or no to choose from. I am sorry, but I have no wish to make enemies of a family of mages. Find someone else to do your task. I'm afraid it's not that simple, though it never is it? You see, you have been allowed into the inner chambers of my guild. You have met me, and you have seen a number of other members. While this knowledge might not directly benefit you, if made known to the guard, it would certainly harm me. I submit to you that I cannot allow this information to leave with someone not of good standing with the guild. Your choice is somewhat limited in this matter. Choose wisely. So we either have to do this for them, or probably fight everyone here, and probably die. Or we can just accept it and just never do it. Well, in that case, it seems like a fairly straightforward bit of burglary, and well within my ability. I accept this challenge and hope it increases my standing within the guild. As it should be. Now that you have agreed, the facilities of the guild are at your disposal. Feel free to make use of them, and make your presence known to the other members. You have my permission, so they will be less likely to kill you on sight. That's good to know. As for your mission, you have a 10-day to complete it. Informants have told me that the Duchess intends to take possession of the components that 10th day, and the exchange will be hosted by Oberon at his estate. As I see it, you have several options. Directly persuade any of the involved parties, to hand over the items, or burgle them out from under their noses. Good luck. Wonderful. Elatos and the Thieves Guild. I have been hired by Elatos Thuibill to do a bit of burglary. I am to sneak into Oberon's estate, and there are still several magical components from the Three Daughters of Chandelier. The components in question are the necessary ingredients for creating a Faerûn flying ship, and the Faerûns want their secret preserved and the items stolen. Elatos suggested that I either persuade the daughters to release the items or spirit them out from under their noses. The items are as followed: a spell book that outlines the rituals needed, a statuette of indeterminate origin, and a fragment of some powerful artifact. I am to return to the Thieves Guild once the items are in my possession. Oh my. Okay. I suppose if I don't do it within the 10 days required, they'll kill me. Is there anybody in here?
Hey, how are things going?
This is a separate area. Nope, there's someone in here. Another rogue.
Hi, friend.
Oh, I can just walk through into here. I didn't realize that. Black Lily. A manual. Can I just take that? I'm stuck.
Sure.
How heavy is this manual? Weight 25. Judging by the arcane symbols printed on its cover, it is clear that this book is imbued with magical properties of one sort or another. Until you attempt to either read or identify it, however, its precise nature will remain unknown to you. Can I just give that to him? Black Lily?
'Twill be the darkest day you never seen, before I don't have what you need.
For the right price, anyway. What will you need today? Remember, cash or hit the bricks. I extend no credit, especially to new recruits. Well, you won't buy my winter wolf pelt, so what good are you? I have to file those away. We do need to get rid of those. I'll tell you this. Arrow of Dispelling. Ooh. Cloak of Protection plus one. What do I have?
What?
This is plus one, but only versus slashing attacks. Save versus death. I think a cloak of protection is plus one to all saves. And she just has a traveler's robe, plus one versus missile. Save versus breath, plus one. I might end up just selling those and getting the cloak of protection. Well, that's if she has two of them.
A simple matter.
I only have one. Yep, plus one AC, all saving throws plus one. Oh, it goes here. Ah, can that be equipped? I couldn't equip it because of the Ring of the Princes plus one. Well, that's a Ring of Wizardry. Need that. So maybe someone else could have a Ring of the Princes. Not be equipped, I guess, because of this. Or the bracers. Or this. The protector. Plus one that, and then... Yeah, it's the same, it just doesn't stack, it's like the same exact effect. It's fire resistance, maybe she can wear it. Nope. Because of this? Yeah. Damn it, I hate that we can't stack these things. Alright, so... we're running out of people who can actually use this. Nope. Maybe because of this? This is regular plate mail. I wonder what's, Oh, Branwyn is Cloak of Protection. Oh, as well. I didn't know that. Okay, that's what's keeping her. I'm being able to use that. Just want to see if anyone can use this. Nope. Thank you. No one can use this ring. Ridiculous. I'm gonna hold on to it for now. Okay.
Go pester someone else. Why me?
Now these look like stairs, but I don't see a way to go down. Does this go out? Just a regular... Oh, goes to a special area. With another rogue.
Sure.
Hi, friend.
Nothing much in here. Alright.
Alright.
Now.
Why me?
What you want?
Good job.
Push a fire breath. Out once again.
Can I assist you?
The Seven Suns has been acting very strange of late. The company seems to be intent on losing money. Even a simple bartender like myself can see the foolishness of some of their decisions. I doubt the Iron Throne is crying about it, though. They're making a lot of inroads because of the Sun's mistakes.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
I've seen that one before. I've heard that one before.
What do you need?
You need something, stranger?
Ooh, a protection scroll, nice. Another rogue.
All right.
Hi, friend.
Picking pockets ain't as profitable as it once was. It's nearly enough to drive a man to honest work. Heaven forbid.
All right.
Slings? Just regular slings and bullets. This is more of the same place. Okay.
All right. Why me?
Pretty big Thieves Guild.
All right.
Okay. We're almost done exploring. I think we'll explore the rest of this quarter of the city and call an episode at that point.
You funny looking!
Can I have a lollipop? Nope, because you said I'm funny looking.
Alms for the poor!
Please, if you will, my lord, spare a coin. Here, take this gold coin. You're a saint, my lord.
What do you need?
What's in here? Like I said, guys, it's gonna take me a long time to explore the city. Oh wait, have we?
Why me?
Been in here? Yep. Okay.
Sure. Why me? Sure.
Thieves Guild has a lot of entrances. Oh. Night falls? Oh no, it's actually dawn. Looks like a carnival or something.
What do you need?
Duke Elton's been mobilizing the Flaming Fist. It's probably because of those Omnian. They're always up to no good. I hear they were behind the trouble with those bandits. Hanging's too good for the likes of them. Indeed.
Hi, friend.
Life's been getting prickly on me, ours.
Oh, this iron shortage is terrible. If it weren't for silverware, I don't know how I'd survive. Let's try in here, whatever this might be. Another one abandoned for 7 years or something.
All right, all right.
All right.
A girl?
I want my mommy.
She says the same thing. Others have said. That's not a bookcase, so I don't think I should mess with that.
All right.
All right, all right. Hey, how are things going?
Nobody up here? Alright.
Why me? Why me?
Bye, little girl.
Sure.
Hello there.
Hello.
Hello there.
And hello.
Can I assist you? Yeah?
Ever since the Iron Throne moved into that mansion in the southwest, strange things have been afoot. I don't know what it is about that building, but it gives me the creeps. There's something strange about the new home of the Iron Throne in the southwest of Baldur's Gate.
Hello there.
Iron's so scarce these days, you'd think it was as valuable as gold. Not a good thing. Not a good thing at all. Iron continues to be scarce, driving prices of
Hello
tools
there.
And weapons even higher.
Yeah?
Hi, friend.
Hey, ain't you those heroes from down south? You guys did real good whooping those bandits' asses. Always wanted to be an adventurer, but you know how things work out. Good luck to all of you. Thanks. Well, this is the upper limits here.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
Yes?
I recognize you. You're those adventurers who've been cleaning up on all the bandits, ain't you? The leader of your bunch is named Sapphire. Why are you up here at the gate? Are you restocking? Or have you come here because there's evil to fight in town? Evil? Here in Baldur's Gate? Why would you think that? Have you heard rumors or any some such? I heard some weird stuff about the merchant consortiums in town. Both the Seven Sons and Merchants League have been acting real strange of late. Then there's that new Iron Throne that just moved in. They took over that huge abandoned tower in the west side of town. Well, that's all I really know. It was nice meeting some real adventurers. Bye now.
Okay. Yes?
Yes. A gold ring. Okay, it appears as if we're done with this section of the city. We know there's more. And we'll be there next episode. Cool. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.